Hey guys, welcome back to my vlogs. Today's the first day, the first last day of 2020. It's the first last day. And I'm just so sad. I'm tearing up because... TK! Is he sure?
Tiny
man.
Your glasses are.
That's what everyone else says.
Hello, people. What the hell's happening? I'm in the camera now. Hello. What the flip was that?
Are you excited?
So Taylor, what's going on? So, what is profanity allowed in the video?
Hey guys, it's day two. It's day two of last second day, and no, I'm just loving it here.
Hey, what are you doing?
Explain it. So, me and Monique are gonna jump, and then you gotta jump.
I watch TikToks.
Ben, come here.
Oh, you're gonna hit my You hit my legs. I know what it is. I've seen.
We're just gonna do like, it's like a little thing. Like, I don't know. Like,
TikTok.
Huh?
TikTok.
No, it's not TikTok.
Oh, what's this?
So, okay, so we're gonna jump at the same time, and then you jump. When we land, you need jump. Okay? Alright, ready? 3, 2, 1.
Monique, how does it feel to be single?
I don't know. I can't answer it.
James, how does it feel to be the biggest kid in school?
This is gay.
How are you and Isabella going?
How are you and Brody?
What do you think of Alec Multurran's Instagram page?
Alec Multurran?
All about himself.
How are you and Jerry Corby going? How does it feel you have dropped the biggest kid, James, multiple times?
I don't know.
Yes, Josh.
It feels alright.
Huh?
It feels alright.
That's good.
Just a question.
Yes.
Just a question.
No, you and James, you guys aren't on good terms, right? How are you and Jermaine doing?
4 by 50
in the real life. I actually know what's coming.
Okay, so I heard at FOMO you all over Fowler. How's that?
We got pictures.
Hey, Kayla, what are your thoughts on Brody?
Good mate.
Good mate.
That's all you get, Brody. Hey, Brody. Any history with Alexis Glogovac?
I just want to know, who broke up with who?
I broke up with her. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's not what I heard.
I'm still scared of Monique to this day, but I broke up with her.
Hello, Jess. What happened with Nathan Baker at Carly's?
Bit of a disaster.
What happened at Carly's with you and Jalen?
Nothing.
Did it really happen?
Nothing.
Nothing happened. Guys, who do you think is the hottest Year 12 boy?
Marco.
I don't have one. You have to say one.
I'd agree with Marco.
Marco. Marco. So, Bryony, what happened with Jay?
Nothing.
Who do you think is the hottest Year 12 boy?
Chloe? Anything?
Rizzo.
Ooh.
Hey, Chloe, didn't you get with Shika?
Who do you think is the hottest Year 12 girl?
Come here.
It's going to be a Yeah. The hottest Year 12 girl?
Yes.
Your mum.
Who is the hottest Year 12 girl?
Eleni.
Oh, I don't know.
Chloe, bro.
Say someone.
I don't know. Chloe Sassine.
There's a bit of tension there.
Oh.
Something happening there. Who do you think is the hottest Year 12 boy?
I already done this.
Oh. I don't know. I mean, Declan's all right, I suppose.
No,
come on, spill the tea. Did Kaylee say someone?
No.
I don't know.
Answer, just pick someone.
Hey, I get shot.
Oh, God, I can't. I don't know.
Say Sam.
What did she say, Marco?
Girls, who's the hottest boy here today?
Who's the hottest?
Hunter Pitch.
I'm just trying to think.
Hunter Pitch!
Stop it. Stop it.
Wait.
Are you okay?
Milan Glogovac.
Oh, yeah, he's got a long neck, doesn't he? Scott, who's the hottest chick here today?
Oh, mate, there's many. I actually don't know. Like, that's actually a good question. You might have to come back to me on that.
Oh, too easy, mate.
Jake Rocker, who's the hottest year 10?
Alex.
Who's the hottest girl here today, boys?
My wife.
I've had a long, hard think about it. I have to be Chloe Sassine.
Alec Mortone. Alec Mortone. Alec Mortone.
Obviously Samuel. Right here, baby. The thick boy.
I'm Aboriginal.
Sweaty, give us a Mickey Mouse impersonation.
Oh, is that what he said?
No. It's the other one.
Go. Yes, you are correct. It's actually Mickey Mouse. All right, Jacob, who's the hottest chick here today?
I'm not really sure, but I might need to say, Chloe.
Yeah.
Hunter Pitch. Who is the hottest girl here today?
I have to go with Alec Mortone. Very nice body. Yeah. All right, so we've got the VCAR boys here. We're going to give you a hard question, all right? So you got to answer. All right, so what's 5 + 5?
10.
7.
Yeah, on your map.
Not as well, she's piss taste.
Oh.
So, how many times have you gone with Tristan?
Cuz, I heard that you've been stabbed 3 times. How did that feel?
Nah, bro. I've been in a hospital a couple of times, you know?
Yeah.
I've said cuz too many times. I kind of OD'd on my own.
Okay, who's the hottest year 12 boy?
No, don't ask me this. Probably. I don't want to say it.
You have boyfriends as well.
I have one, but like I don't want to say it.
Just say it.
Say it.
Everyone else.
Probably Marco. Yeah.
You?
Yeah, I would agree. Yeah. Marco.
Who's the hottest year 12 girl?
I'm pressured now. I don't know. I can't give you an answer. I'm sorry.
Do you want to think about it and come back?
How does it feel that team helped you on the Talia Snapchat?
Sir, to be honest, I've got to let you know.
What's this, sir?
There's one B word that I'm cool with. That's beautiful.
You're the man.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Think on the spot.
I am connected with the Calabrian Mafia, I want to know.
Oh.
My family comes from Griffith.
Sorry, sir, who's your favourite student?
I have no favourite. You're all loved by me. Please don't tell people I'll get arrested.
India, how does it feel stealing two of your best friend's exes? Right. Actually stole 3 of them. How does it feel? Great.
Can you tell us exactly what happened at the night of Joey's party?
So you know. It was an accident. we were next to the DJ booth, you know. Things just got out of hand. I mean, out of fingers. I mean.
Where's Jake? Can you just please listen up? How do you feel about Monique and Jake finally breaking up? Can you slide in now? Me and Monique are actually friends now, so shit.
Can you tell me what you and Natalia did at Jerry's house?
We actually just laid on a bed, that's pretty much it.
Laid on a bed, oh.
Alright, Milan, any opinions on Tamsin Kirk?
Who's hotter, my brother or Jake's brother?
Look, I'm gonna have to give Liam this.
Yeah!
Poor Luca, man.
What do I say?
I don't know, where is it? Just press it and talk.
Well, look, it's actually like a
the spider legs come out every time.
Yeah. Lavina, Do you ever think you'll get a boyfriend? Yes, I actually
no, she's right
now. I actually have one right now.
Oh, who?
You gonna shit on the floor again?
Joy!
It's actually smashed. Oh,
serious, Joy!
Smash him blood, smash him!
Is this Gabby's phone?
Is it mad at you that George has broke your phone?
Yeah, a little mad.
It goes like this and goes yeah.
Milan, is it true you want to get with Alyssa and Natalia's?
No comment.
Hey, Daniel.
Yep.
How does it feel that your girlfriend broke up with you over text?
Oh, look, it feels great. Really, really upends the self-esteem. Makes me feel a lot better.
Are you still in love with Jalen? From like year
no.
three?
No.
Yes. Yes, I'm like, yes.
Give you the daily update. We have 1,191 confirmed cases of coronavirus. Play our part, do the right thing, do the decent thing. If you can stay home, you must stay home. A very big step, a massive step that is essential to keep Victorians and Australians safe. Bring forward the school holidays to plan for remote, flexible, distance learning. School is going to look very different in term two. If you can learn from home, you must learn from home.
It's soccer and football.
Wait, derby.
We are at the annual Aitken Derby Day in 2020 with soccer versus football. Footy's up 1-0. The Aussies are winning.
Serious question. What the hell were you thinking?
We're just wondering if your shoes come in some women's sizes.
Because damn. We want a copper pair.
Yeah, we do.
You're breaking my office. I come in and interview me and break my office.
Okay, ready? What will you miss most from the year?
It's like I'm holding like some sort of mouse or something.
What will I miss most? I think term one, if I go back to term one, sneaking out with a group of kids going to the local pub. But don't tell Miss Crisara that.
I probably miss the chats with groups of U12s coming into my office. Got a pretty good relationship with a lot of them, and always got people like you coming in here to ask me questions and have a bit of a convo, so that's probably something I'll miss most.
I think what I'll miss most is, you know, the sort of spunk of the group, the cheeky personalities within this cohort. It's been really hard this year. I feel like we haven't been able to, you know, connect with you guys like we normally would. But, you know, I've known you guys since year seven, and yeah, definitely the cheekiness of the group.
Themselves not being here at all, and they haven't been here all year, unfortunately.
Oh, look, I will actually miss all the Zooms because I found them really casual. It was very nice just to talk to the students and catch up with them every day. We spent hours talking on Zoom.
I think I'll just miss everybody's fun personalities and having a good old chit chat with everybody as well.
At sport and rec class, a lot of fun. I'm not going to miss Brody's haircut, and I'm not going to miss Daniel Scadella's ears or Sarah Zugan's aggressiveness, but just the class in general. I'm going to miss them.
A little bit biased here. I'll miss the class that I taught this year. In terms of students that I've had a lot to do with over the year, probably miss Tristan Gencarelli's hair. It's just immaculate, so silky, smooth, goes all the way back to grade 5. Once emailed me a photo of what conditioner he used. Just, there's a little bit of oil for everyone there. And I'm now on the same type of conditioner myself, so.
I think this year 12 group had really good conversations and chat. I remember, you know, just throughout the years, even from all the way back in grade 6, you were a very interesting and talkative group. So I think I'll miss having conversations with you all.
The change, I'll be honest with you, you guys coming into year 12, we were sort of a bit on edge because, let's face it, when you guys were in year 10, there was a reputation developing, but you guys just seem to have matured and turned into, this is going to pain me to say it, beautiful young people.
I'm going to miss the most just communication with them. I really love communicating with my year 12s and having chats with them, so that is what I'm going to miss the most.
The people. Over a couple of years, you get to know a group of students quite well for different reasons. And with this group, there's actually been very, very few bad reasons. So I'll just actually miss the individual people, the interactions, the conversations, the funny moments, screaming at the odd person. But it's just basically the people that I'll miss.
I will miss a lot of distractions. Because there were a lot of cheeky people. Students, I would say, and I remember a lot of them trying to bunk their classes throughout their career, but especially in year 12, I had some culprits. That's what I am going to miss.
I'm hoping it might be a girl this year because I feel like we've had lots of guys over the last few years.
Alma Fudd. Rabbit season, duck season, rabbit season, duck season. Obviously, I'm showing my... Go watch Bugs Bunny cartoons.
Everybody, because they're all winners.
Declan, maybe? Yeah, I could not tell you on that one. That's going to be really, really close, I think.
Oh my God, I have no idea who's going to get ducks. Whoever it is, hire me as your PA.
Helena Riley.
Look, I believe that everybody can, whatever they set their mind to, they can do. So I honestly think that it is open to everybody. As long as you try your best in your exams, I know that all of you will do well. But yeah, I can't put a name to it. It's too hard.
Oh, look, where do we begin?
How long have we got?
Just not doing their work when I've asked them to. It's very annoying.
Argue a point that's non-defensible. So, you know, COVID stuff's happening and, you know, there are certain rules put in place and still arguing and knowing that we can't do anything about it.
Your year level in year 10, full stop. I can't add any more to that.
Look, this year has been such a positive year because we didn't see you for so long. But in terms of what I said earlier, the fact that you guys just seem to have grown up and become really nice people that you can have decent conversations with. You seem to have a path that you're all following, and I think you speak volumes for about the good stuff we do at this school, because you're a credit to the school, and when you guys leave, you're taking part of the school with you, and you're taking part of the teachers with you when you go out, and I think that's what I'm going to, more than anything, think about you this year. You've been such a pleasant surprise.
Can I blame you for coronavirus? Because if I can, that's it.
I've been friends with Ben Lommy. So that's a bit disappointing. They could have done better.
Look, again, I'll talk about it from the health perspective because it's been I've most recently had all of you, but rewriting the question. I don't know how many more times I need to say, don't rewrite the question, and they start rewriting the question. So for me, that's probably the most annoying thing that you do.
Grow taller, Milan.
Nothing really comes to mind, although we do have tomorrow. It could end up being that.
It's probably over the years, people not being nice to each other. That really grinded my gears when I was your assistant out of school. People that couldn't say nice things, they'd say the opposite. That's annoying. But you've got better, I think.
A year 12 that I can see myself in.
I can be very indecisive, so I'm going to nominate Taylor Chan.
Definitely Erin. She's got it all.
Believe it or not, Hunter Petch, because there's an element of him that is very easygoing and just goes with the flow and has a direction that he knows he's heading in and doesn't necessarily mesh with everyone else's, but he's just a decent guy.
There's bits and pieces of lots of year 12s that I can see myself in. I think with my health class, I have a lot of sporty kids in there that just love sport. So for those of you that did sport, you know, that part of me I loved, and I can see myself in those people with that. And then again with health, it's a topic that I love to teach, and the health side of it as well. So healthy eating and that kind of thing. I know that a lot of people did health for that reason. So I see myself in all those people, but again, one particular person, not so much, but there's qualities in every single person that I see myself in year 12s.
I'm gonna go Joseph Miko. He loves his sport. I reckon he parties hard.
A lot, too many to mention, because they have little personalities that I can see in myself that make up the full me.
Luke Shikitano was a smart ass, and I hate him, and I'm a self-loathing person, and I hate myself. But he reminds me of me, and that's not a good thing.
Now, none of you guys measure up to my standards. No, seriously. I see a lot of these young people, and I'm just amazed at how together you are compared to how useless I was at your age. And I see you guys planning for your future, studying, doing all those sort of things. And even though it's a different time, I just think, no, I wasn't that together. You guys are doing so much better, I think, than a lot of people were back when I was a young lad.
Are you allowed to even, like, touch?
Is there what? Sorry?
Is there a sorry? That I ship? Yeah. What does that mean?
Is there a...
couple that you ship?
That I ship?
Two...
Ah, speaking English!
I don't even know what those words mean when they're put together in that order.
That I ship? What do you mean?
Is that a thing?
Yeah.
Did you understand that? Like...
No, I didn't.
Yeah, all right, there we go.
Perhaps Rizzo and Monique.
No.
I don't even know who's couples anymore. It's so hard.
Okay, this is what I do in class, actually. I pair people up. I see Jaden with someone. I want to be invited to your engagement party.
No.
No?
I have nothing else. I don't even know who he is.
Oh, it's got to be Blake and Carly, doesn't it?
Oh, Liv and JJ. Without a doubt. Yeah. They're just, like, adorable. They really are. Like two little puppies following each other around.
I'd probably go Tristan and India for that one. There's something there. Bit of chemistry.
This one. Bianca and Tristan. Are they?
Sorry?
Doesn't matter.
All the best. We know it's been a really hard year and we completely understand. We've been along the journey with you. Just have a really good go and have a great summer. It's going to be the greatest summer of your lives.
It's supposed to rain, so carry an umbrella. And don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Plead not guilty.
How long's this video got to go for? I mean, I could launch into this now. We could be here 3 hours later. So I repeat myself a little bit from year to year. But what I'll say to you, go out and think for yourselves and question the narrative. In life, you'll be receiving a narrative from society. You don't have to go along with it. Think for yourself and question what you've been told.
You're going to make me emotional again. Probably start crying again. I do, just to follow your dreams. You've all worked so hard, especially under the circumstances that you've been in. So whatever you set your mind to, go for it. And I know that any of you and all of you can achieve anything that you put your minds to. VCE is extremely important, but at the end of the day, as long as you all get into what you want to get into and do whatever you do, that's the most important part.
What you have learnt this year is something that you will carry with you forever. Perseverance and determination.
Now, I don't know when you're going to see this one, but if you see it before the exam, just do the best, leave the rest.
The fact that we've been smashed by COVID and we've been doing a lot of remote learning, so it's probably the thing that I'll remember the most from this year as a whole.
With the absolute nonsense that's gone on this year, there's so many moments that are memorable for the wrong reasons. For me, I think what's been good on those couple of occasions when we've had the lockdown go home, when we've come back to school and just actually seeing students in the corridor, students coming into the office, students and teachers working together, classes running, yelling at people for the wrong thing. That's been the memorable moment in terms of the school for me, just those couple of times when we've actually come back together after having been forced apart again.
Zooming.
We've been at school and then we haven't been at school. But the most memorable one for me was honestly just my teaching of my first year in year 12 and rocking up to class for the first time and still calling them all year 11s, even though they were in year 12. And finally, by the end of the year, I got it right. But that was really memorable for me. And also just how resilient that you've been, especially while we did home learning with our Zoom lessons, etc. That has been, yeah, memories.
I think possibly trying to teach behind a mask has been memorable. Accepting everybody into Zooms and trying to watch people or not watch people as well. Just general laughs. I always like anything to laugh at or with.
Sarah Zugan going full Kung Fu master and like just kicking people in my PE class, my vet sport rec class, and just generally beating up on children. That was... and maybe Daniel Scadella actually answering a question correctly in vet sport and rec was a bit of a highlight too. The lowest ATAR. Well, if Jake Rocker actually turns up to his exams, I'll be pleasantly surprised. So he might be my pick there.
Probably Kayla. Kayla's asking the questions, by the way.
Second, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she is waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses asking about a scar. And I know I gave it to you months ago. I know you're trying to forget, but between the drinks and subtle things, the holes in my apologies, you know, I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.
Fire.
the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.